Crusaders united a powerful army for a fateful battle against Lithuania's great dukedom and Kingdom of Poland. Many warriors came from conquered Prussian lands, Martinburg, Elbing, Kalm, Bulgar, Regen, Braunschweig towns. 4,000 warriors gathered from the Western Europe in Martinburg. Jogan Voigt, historian of the Horde, wrote that among noble knights there were 3 kings, 23 dukes, 21 margraves and 58 grafs. Entire army of Horde consisted of 51 regiments which used to be called flags. Crusaders' army might have been from 15 to 21,000 well-armed warriors. The great Duke Vytautas and the King of Poland Jagiela brought from 21 to 29,000 warriors to the Horde lands. Vytautas commanded the 41 regiments. Warriors who were fighting under 10 flags of columns of Gediminas were from Tragai, Kaunas and Vilnius. The flag of Vytautas was taken in the lands of Gardiners, Nordgardukes and Vytautas. There were 2,000 Tatars in Vytautas' forces. The total amount of warriors in Vytautas' forces could be 11,000. Poland army consisted of 51 flags, which are 18,000 warriors. Jagiela commanded to allied army, but in the battlefield Lithuania's great dukedom and Poland army was commanded by Vytautas. July 15, 1410. Both armies met between Tonnenberg and Grunwald villages. On the right wing in front of Lithuania's great dukedom army, Crusaders lined 15 heavily armored knights up. They were being commanded by Friedrich von Wallander. On his side, under a flag St. George, there were gathering knights come from the western part of the Europe. On the left wing, in front of Polish, the Horde lined 20 flags, which were being commanded by Conrad Liechtenstein. The very master of Horde Ulrich von Jungingen with 16 flags left himself in the back. There were made barricades, wolf traps, and bombardiers' positions in front of the Crusaders' battle lines. They were covered by infantry, crossbowers and shooters of the Horde. Lithuania's great dukedom's 41 flags lined up in 3 lines on the right wing, in front of Friedrich von Wallenrode's flags. The first 17 flags arms line of Poland Kingdom, commanded by Jagiela, gathered on the outskirts of forest. At the beginning of the battle they formed one line, which was visible for Crusaders, and ended up in front of Conrad Liechtenstein's flags. German knights had been waiting for the attack for 3 hours. They encouraged Master of Horde to start the battle, because brightly shining sun was hazing them. They could start the battle themselves. On forest outskirts, dislocated army of Poland didn't let heavy cavalry maneuver, which was a powerful force of the Horde. In order to provoke Jagiela and Vytautas attack, Ulrich von Jungingen sent 2 heralds, who gave 2 swords to Jagiela and Vytautas, and dropped an insulting phrase. With help of these swords, maybe you will choose the correct place. Don't hide in the forest, and don't delay the fight, because it's inevitable. Jagiela and Vytautas replied, "We accept the swords, and with the help of God, we are going to fight with Master, for the justice, and God will choose a place of the battle." The battle started at 11 o'clock. Lithuania's great dukedom started the attack. Crusaders, bombardiers and shooters managed to release only a few rounds, when they were attacked and wiped out by Lithuanian knights. However, They were met by Friedrich von Wallander's heavy Crusaders Knights cavalry. Lithuanian arrows used to bounce from knights' armor by making a low damage. German knights collided into Lithuania's Great Dukedom light cavalry. People were fighting and weapons were smashing. A furious massacre lasted for longer than half an hour. When spears got broken, warriors were fighting with axes and daggers. Soon, Friedrich von Wallander brought the second lineup of knights into the battle. Then Lithuanian warriors, being not able to resist the attack, started retreating. The second line of warriors was sent to help. Warriors were from Lithuanian lands, Trikai, Kaunas, Vilnius. Unfortunately, they couldn't resist the pressure. Despite the big loss, they were standing their ground. The third Lithuania's Great Dukedom cavalry joined the battle. However, even it didn't take an avalanche of knights. At that moment, Polish regiments started moving on the left wing. After 1 hour from the beginning of the battle, Lithuania's Great Dukedom army unexpectedly performed retreating maneuver. Then, in the battlefield, there were only a part of the army and three regiments from Smolensk Kaz, which were fighting against the Crusaders. Believing that Lithuanians are running away from the battlefield, the Master of Horde sent 9 flags after Lithuanians and 6 flags after Polish army, with intention to surround them from the right and behind. But at this moment, the way was blocked by 3 brave regiments of Smolensk Kaz, which was commanded by Poland King's brother, Duke Lingvnis. German forces jumped on Smolensk Kaz regiments and eliminated 1 unit. However, 2 Smolensk Kaz regiments succeeded in standing the attack of the cavalry of Friedrich von Wallander. Allied armies staggered, so the government of the Horde believed in their victory. The great comptroller of the Horde, Liechtenstein, and Marshal Wallander attacked Poland and regiments of Smolensk Kaz with full power. They started to retreat. The great Poland flag of Krakow fell down. Crusaders started chanting their victory song, "Jesus is resurrected," and started lining up for the last attack. Seeing that Crusaders were almost done overtaking Polish lines, Jagiela sent the second line of the Polish army. After furious fight, Crusaders were neutralized. Then, using the old war method of Tartars, allegedly split up Lithuania's Great Dukedom regiments, gathered and surrounded the chasers. They were all eliminated. Polish army began to put the impact on Liechtenstein warriors. The last line swung, and due to the high pressure, flags of Helm left the battle. It was obvious that initiative was on the other side. Then, the Master of Horde, Ulrich von Jungingen, got into the battle with 16 reserved Crusaders flags. He didn't know that Lithuania's Great Dukedom army was getting on the battlefield. The flags of Master tried to overcome fighting regiments from the right wing. Here Crusaders faced Polish warriors. Jagiela sent 16 flags. In the mess of the battle, 1 Crusaders unit disaffiliated from formation and accidentally approached to Jagiela headquarters. One of the attackers tried to kill the leader of Poland with a spear, but was eliminated by the escort of the king. Others didn't realize that they had attacked the king, turned to the main regiments to attack. Masters and marshals' men attacked several times, but couldn't overcome the defensive Polish lines. Furiously fighting and attacking regiments of Horde, didn't notice Lithuania's Great Dukedom regiments coming back to the battlefield. They, led by Vytautas, hid Crusaders from the side and from behind. Master of Horde, Ulrich von Jungingen, Marshal Wallander, and the great Kontorkan raid Liechtenstein were surrounded. In two rings of encirclement, elimination of crusaders began. The great master of Horde refused to evacuate himself, and, with his crusaders, fought till the end. He died from the spear of Lithuanian's infantryman. From the encirclement escaped only leftovers of six flags of Horde. Other were killed, or taken as prisoners. On the left wing of encirclement, Polish totally surrounded Conrad Liechtenstein's unit. From the grip of Polish army, only six flags of the Great Comtor could escape. Escaped warriors tried to defend themselves near Frogeni area, but the campsite was overtaken by assault. Allied army chased running crusaders for 30 kilometers. The battle ended in 9 o'clock in the evening. The battle took 10 hours to end. Crusaders were destroyed. The highest ranks of Horde were killed. Master Aldriek von Jungingen, Marshal Friedrich von Wallander, the great Kontorkan raid Liechtenstein. To prison was taken the Duke of Schtken Casimieres, Duke of Welsh Conrad, and forthcoming Master of Horde Mikolas Kirkmesteris. On that day, Crusaders lost 200 leaders and 14,000 warriors. Lithuania's great dukedom army also had a big loss. 1/3 warriors were lost in the battle. Polish weren't so badly damaged. According to Jan Glukosz, only 10 regiments were killed. On that day, 15th of July, 1410, Zalgiris battle shocked the Western Europe, which thought that Horde is invincible. The elimination of crusaders topped almost 200 years lasted aggression of German knights, and the Western Europe directed towards Lithuania, Poland, and other lands of Baltic.